Welcome to the LTE Uplink Single Carrier FDMA tutorial. In the following tutorial, we'll learn why LTE uses single carrier FDMA for providing high data rate to the uplink radio channel, and what are the differences between OFDMA used in the downlink channel to single carrier FDMA used in the uplink channel. LTE downlink uses OFDMA in order to cope with the multipass, delay spread, and inter-symbol interference. The OFDMA symbols are made of long-duration symbols and multiple subcarriers, where the incoming data symbols are mapped to be modulated separately on each subcarrier. OFDM is indeed very robust in terms of delay spread and inter-symbol interference. This is a significant advantage. But the OFDM has also a significant disadvantage, and this is the relatively high peak to average power ratio. So in order to understand what is peak to average power ratio, we should look at the following figure. This figure describes the momentary power emitted from the OFDMA transmitter. We can see that the power map of the transmitter is characterized by relatively low average and high power peaks. In OFDMA, the typical power peak to average power ratio is in the magnitude of 10 dBs. It depends on the number of subcarriers used. It depends also on the modulation. But in the average, the probability to have 10 dB peak to average is relatively high. So what does it mean? It means that in order to transmit an average of 200 milliwatts, 0.2 watt, the power amplifier needs to be capable to handle peaks of about 2 watts, 10 times higher, 10 dB higher. In other words, it means that the power amplifier will be significantly non-efficient. And in other words, it means high battery power consumption. So this is regarded as a significant disadvantage, especially when we talk about mobile communication technology, where the at least part of the units are powered by battery. This graph shows the peak to average power ratio of OFDM. It depends, of course, on the number of subcarriers used for the OFDM modulation, but it can be seen that in the average, the typical number for anything between 500 to 2,000 subcarriers is about 10 dB peak to average power ratio. So in order to cope with this problem, meaning in order to reduce the peak to average power ratio and increase the efficiency of the power amplifier and save battery life, LTE uses a different access mode for the uplink. So what we see in the left side of this slide is the OFDMA used in downlink. This is a kind of reminder. We use in the downlink multiple subcarriers. Each of them is colored with a different color that lasts for relatively long symbol duration. This is OFDMA. Each of the subcarriers is modulated by a different data symbol. And this modulation and this symbol lasts for relatively long duration. At the right side of the slide, we see single carrier FDMA used in the uplink. So also the single carrier is actually a multiple carrier. But all subcarriers in the uplink are modulated with the same data, are modulated with the same data. So it is shown in this figure by the fact that the first group, the first green group of subcarriers have the same color all around the physical resource block, and this is the green group, modulated by the same data. But as we can see in this slide, it lasts for much shorter time. It means that effectively the symbol is much shorter. So it brings us back to the situation where we need to deal with short symbols. So actually, LTE uses two separate methods for the uplink and the downlink. For the downlink, OFDMA is used. It's less efficient in terms of power amplifier efficiency, but it is less critical since the power amplifier resides at the base station. And the base station is much more tolerant to power consumption, heat dissipation, and so on. And it transmits the OFDMA to the handle device, where the receiver copes with the multipass and the inter-symbol interference phenomena without equalizer. It means that the handle device can be implemented with relatively low processing power, which again, it is very important at the handle device side. On the other end, at the uplink, it is very important to have a very efficient power amplifier at the handle device side. So single carrier FDMA is used. At the receiver side of the uplink, which resides at the base station, an equalizer is used. But again, the base station is much less sensitive to cost, to power dissipation, to processing power, and it can tolerate the existence of the equalizer. So by having two different access modes for the uplink and the downlink, actually, most of the burden in terms of power dissipation and processing power was taken from the handle device and put into the base station, which is much less sensitive to these parameters. Let's have a look at the way that OFDM and single carrier OFDM are being generated. OFDM is generated actually by inverse FFT on a stream of data that is mapped to each of the ports of the IFFT processor. This creates the required modulation and in the time domain, and this is the signal that it is transmitted through the air. Again, the incoming data is modulating separately each subcarrier. This is the result of this process. At the receiver side, the subcarriers are being received, go through the receiver to the FFT, and after being processed by the FFT, the data is being reconstructed. This is the way that OFDM is generated. In order to generate signal carrier FDMA, a certain addition needs to be added to the basic OFDMA generator. And this is an FFT processor before of the inverse FFT. This actually maps a large group of bits to all subcarriers that take part in a certain LTE symbol. In this way, all subcarriers are actually modulated with the same data, and the equivalent impact of a single carrier is created. As a result, the peak to average power ratio of single carrier FDMA is improved by 3 to 6 dB. This is very significant, because 3 dB is half the power. half the power is 6 times lower current consumption. So it means that by going from OFDMA to single carrier OFDM, power consumption in terms of battery life can be extended by a magnitude to 4 to 6, and this is significant. This concludes this session. Hope you enjoyed it. We welcome you to look for our other tutorials on LTE and other topics.